expected more than three, but fortunately, just three is okay. We can, you can handle them. Okay, we will hear afterwards Mr. Veriopoulos' comments on that. Now, let me turn to our next speaker, who is Mr. Konstantinos Tomaras, Deputy CEO from Spyropoulos Company. You have the floor.
Hello, everybody. I'm very happy for being here. First of all, I would like to thank HAEE for organizing this beautiful symposium, and personally, Mr. Andrisopoulos for his invitation. Now, I personally agree to most of the things that previous speakers have already talked about. We see the world from the same perspective, from the wind and the solar. On my behalf, my company is a developer and contractor and on solar parks. And on that side, it is a puzzling equation, the development in the Greek market, taking into consideration the need for renewable energy, but taking into the same equation all the difficulties facing by the investors or the other participants in the market like companies. So I'm just going to go very quickly on the company, on the presentation, very, very quickly. It's a brief company profile. The need for the photovoltaic sector will be from the global development, the Greek development market, based on the new target model and the regulatory framework, and some concerns that I want to share with you based on that, on the previous topics. Now, the company, I already told you, it is a operating and maintenance company, developing company, and EPC contractor in three fields, photovoltaic construction and wind generation, starting in 2004. And now has a big portfolio in has a good portfolio for the Greek market in terms of installed capacity and OEM operation and maintenance client base and development. I'm gonna let this through, and so these are our. Some of our clients that put trust in us through all these years. And now, let me show you some things. Every year, the projections for the solar and the wind need are increasing. As we can see in this graph, solar is increasing more than wind globally. And this is a very difficult equation for us to solve based on the Kyoto Protocol and all the the other, let's say, from the Paris Agreement and the penetration that should be done for every country to put more penetration in renewable energy. So, thankfully, all the technologies that we are talking about throughout the years tend to lower their price, the construction price in solar, in wind, in carbon capture and storage, in vehicle batteries, efficient lighting, etc., etc. So this gives us to us the need to evolve more in renewable energy and in PV and wind. Moreover, the European Commission, as we know, has a target for every EU state. We see how that evolves. We have still a way to go. So this is a very good promising factor that we have to take into consideration. Plus, bearing into account the increase in the carbon price, market price, which lets the solar and the wind and other renewable technology penetrate more in a global market, and so also in the Greek market. I skip this slide. Now, there are recent, as we have heard from our notable speakers throughout this symposium, new regulatory framework in the Greek market based on the new model, on free market model, the target model, which will be in a and the energy exchange, which will be in a transitional period for up to 2021, and then we'll move to the free market, full free market stage. We have increased competition and lower bid prices based on the tender processes that have been implemented by the regulator, the regulator authority, which has made a huge impact on lowering the price, so as to avoid things that happened in the past, and we all remember what happened 10 years ago. There is a further involvement and incentives for energy communities in the Greek market and farmers to evolve in solar installations. There is also a new regulatory framework in place for out-of-tender projects, which is implemented in 2019 and 2020. And there is a lot of increased interest from investors, with which we'll see as a record in applications for tenders in December 2018 and the recent tender that took place in April. I borrowed this slide from the Solar Association, which shows the which shows how the market was, how the market is now, and how it is going to develop. So now the market again opened, and from a stagnant period, we enter into a very high period. And these are some figures that we need to take into our mind, that they are targets for solar in the Greek market, also borrowed from the Energy Association. Now, this is also what the new model is going to take place, the new target model with the four markets that are going to be placed in the current regulatory framework. So the futures market, daily market, intraday market, and balancing market. I don't want to put further information on that. I just want to say that this is a slide of how the things are going to work since July. And this is a totally different view from what we have used to up to now. And now, what are the, since we have the needs and we have the need to, since we have the needs to enter into the renewable energy, what are the constraints? There is increasing interest in investing versus delays that have been wisely also posed by other speakers. Licensing delays from local authorities, lack of personnel from HAEE, we know that, to manage this huge amount of applications, lack of investors' information on grid capacity. So it's a huge risk on the investor side, how they're going to decide if there is no evident knowledge of how the grid is operating at the moment, or how many applications are at the moment on hold. Increasing interest in investing versus also some increased guarantee costs. I understand why we have increased guarantee costs if I can imagine what happened 10 years ago. However, it is discouraging versus other countries that have less guarantees in to put in place, like Spain, for example. But this wouldn't have been a problem if the procedure would be quick. This is a problem because the procedure is not quick enough. So if you have to put a big guarantee for 2 months, it's not a big problem. If you have to put a guarantee for 1 year or 6 months or 8 months, then it is a problem, I think, which has to be solved. Increasing interest versus small private investments will face also some difficulties to be materialized, mainly for out-of-tender projects, because nowadays, the view is to go on larger scale projects with increasing the amount of putting bigger companies into the game, plus also the communities, which give a social view on these investments. So, suggestions, quick. Maybe if we put all this together in a one-stop energy spot for investors, in order to have for the licensing procedure one stop for all the development phase, one person or one energy point, let's say. Online information, more online information that we still have about current applications per regions or capacity grid level per region. Some better coding for the legal framework that currently exists and is puzzling for somebody to read and to take into consideration all the recent changes that happened this year. Special land uses should be also taken in place. More personnel, probably, or a computerized application process, just like former speaker said. Re-evaluate also the comparative advantages of our country and lowering some guarantees for entering into the development scene, especially when such delays takes place. So, this was all. Thank you very much for your time. I hope I was not very, I am 2.5 minutes out of time. I'm terribly sorry. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mr. Tomaras. We will come again later to your